वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अवर सेशन ऑफ कॉरपोरेट फिनेंस. नाउ एज फार एज आर लास्ट सेशन वॉज कंसर्न, इन दैट वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड द वेरिएबल्स ऑफ क्रेडिट पॉलिसी. नाउ टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट determinants of size of receivables. Now at what level we are going to decide our receivables, that how much credit is going to allowed to our customers. There are few factors, there are few determinants who directly judge the size of organization's receivable. Many organization can enjoy a large number of receivables. That is totally depends upon many factors of that particular company. While few organization deals with a small amount of receivables, that is totally depends upon the factors that connect or that directly engage with the determinants of receivables. So there are basically four types of factors, or we can say that determinants who decides the size of receivables, or we can say that the level of receivables that any organization can have. Under that, the first one is volume of credit sales. Now we can say that this is the one of the first factor through which the company is going to judge that how much credit sales they are going to allow to their customers to increase their market share and to raise their credit policy. As we already know that with the help of maximum sales, the company is able to maximize their market shares. But somehow, it is not possible for each and every organization that is to decide the credit policy on the basis of their market share. Because in few organizations, they are not able to utilize their production capacity at the fullest level. So when capacity is not going to be utilized, at the same time company is not able to maximize their sales by allowing maximum credits to their customers. So if any organization wishes to raise their sales, and that is also with the help of credit, then first and foremostly it is highly required for any organization that is to increase their production capacity. And with an increment in the production capacity, a company is able to manage a large number of receivables with their maximum capacity of production. Second one, that is credit policies. As we already know that there are two types of credit policy. The first one, that is strict credit policy, and the second one, that is liberal credit policy. Now in strict credit policy, organization apply a strict standards for their customers to allow credits to them. And in liberal credit policy, the standards, the criterias are somehow liberal, and customer get easily credits from the organization. So now here we are going to analyze that which credit policy is going to adopted by the organization. If the working capital is going to be managed in a proper manner, if company is able to manage their credits, so at the same time company will enjoy a large number of receivables. So it is totally depends upon the credit policy that the company is adopted. If strict credit policy is there, then there is a shortage of working capital and company is not able to enhance their credit sales because they are in the shortage of working capital. But if liberal credit policy is there, then we can easily judge that company is able to manage their working capital in a proper manner so that they can enjoy a large number of sales by allowing maximum credits to them. Then after, third factor, that is the period of credit. Now, but obvious, the size of receivable is directly related with the period of credits which organization allows to their customer. If the credit period is for the longest period of time, then company enjoy maximum receivables, or we can say that they are able to get the large number of customers. But if the credit policy is for the short period of time, then again the size of receivables will be minimum to minimum. So it is totally depends upon the period of credit that the company is going to allow to their customers. And period of credit is totally depends upon the movement of cash in the organization. So it directly upon the working capital requirement or availability of working capital in the organization. So period of credit also decide the size of receivables. Simply, if the period of credit is for the short period of time, then the company have a small group of receivables. And if the period of credit is for the longest period of time, then the company have a large number of customers. Then after, fourth determinants is about cash discount. If organization gives maximum cash discount on cash purchase, then the size of receivable is minimum to minimum, because now customer gets the financial benefit out of the cash discount, then why they are going to pay the full amount after a few periods of time? So they can enjoy this discount facility by paying on cash. So definitely, if the rate of cash discount is maximum, then the size of receivable is minimum. And if company will not allow any kind of discount to their customers, then definitely the size of receivable will be maximum to maximum. So these are the few determinants through which the receivables are going to be analyzed by the organization at the time of adopting the credit standards for their customers. Now the next point, forecasting of receivables. Now here company is going to make an estimation for their receivables, that is for their debtors. Here few formulas are also there, a simple example is also there, then we are going to calculate in our next session. Now first let's have the discussion of our forecasting of different factors when we are calculating our receivables. Now first one, that is forecasting sales. As we already know that the main part or the base of receivable is the sales. If sales is there, then and then the questions of receivable may arise. So first step for the estimations of the receivables, that is to decide or that is to estimate the level of sales that the organization is going to have in the near future. If the forecasting is done on a proper basis with the proper techniques and with the reliable data, then company can easily manage their receivables with the proper forecasting of sales. Now, by doing the forecasting of sales, company may use their current data, that how much they are able to produce, how much they are able to purchase, that is the purchase of raw material, then what is the actual demand of their product in the market, what is the movement of competitors in the market, what is the competitor's strategy, then what is the government policy, then after what is the market movement and what will be the future market movement for our product only. So while having the forecasting of these particular things, the company can easily forecast their sales. Generally, forecasting is done on the basis of past and present data. And with the help of this data, the company can easily make rough estimations about the future sales. Then after, second one is forecasting cash discount. Now here, company is going to make an estimation about the cash discount that they are going to allow to their customers who are purchasing on cash. Basically, if the financial position of the company is really very sound, if the working capital is going to be managed in a proper manner, then company can easily allow cash discounts to their customers. Sometimes it happens that in receivables, the company is not able to recover their borrowings from the market. So at that time, they are not going to allow maximum credits to their customer. But if the company adopt the strict credit policy for their customers, and on the basis of that credit policy, if the customer, they are paying on time and with a proper amount, then definitely the rate of cash discount will be minimized. So it is totally based upon the situation, that how your customers are going to react, what are their purchasing power, how they are going to adopt or how they are going to accept the policies of organization that is about the receivables. So it is totally based upon the estimation, it is a forecasting. So we are not able to get the 100% of idea on the basis of forecasting, but company can make a rough estimation on the basis of the forecasting, which is done with the help of reliable data. Then after, third one, that is forecasting average collection period. Yes, the average collection period is totally based upon the credit cycle of the organization, that how much capital is required to satisfy their working capital need. So if the average collection period is really very high, and if the company is not able to manage their receivables in the past, then definitely company will allow a shortest period of collection period in the near future, because it is truly said that forecasting is done on the basis of past data and the present situation. Hence, on the basis of past data and the present situation, the company is going to make an estimation that how their customer will react when they are going to change the average collection period for the shortest period of time. It is totally based upon the reaction of their customers. And the last one, that is forecasting account receivable. Account receivable is totally depends upon the estimated sales and estimated turnover ratio of accounts receivable, that how much they are paying to organization when the credit limit is going to be completed, when the collection period is going to be completed. At that time they are going to make an analysis of the account receivables. So in a nutshell, we can say that the receivables are going to react on the basis of our forecasting techniques. If our forecast is really very strong, if it is totally based upon the reliable data, it is totally based upon the real situation of the market, then definitely company will enjoy their receivables without any chance of default. Then after, few formulas are there. Under that, the first one, that is estimated receivables, are there. Now estimated receivables is equal to estimated sales, that is divided by account receivable turnover, or we can say that account receivable turnover period. And account receivable turnover, that is equal to 360 days divided by average collection period, that how much period it will take to collect your credit. The formula is already given on the page number 264. Then after, the next one is cash discount. Now the formula of cash discount is equal to estimated sales into percentage of customers into the rate of discount that organization allow at the time of purchase on cash basis. So this formula, on the basis of this formula, we can estimate that how much cash discount the company will allow to their customers. If the amount of cash discount is really very high, if it is increasing, then definitely it will cost or it is a one kind of expenditures for the organization. So company tries to reduce the rate of discount on the cash purchase. And the last one, that is forecasting accounts receivable. Now that is equal to estimated sales, which is divided by account receivable turnover. Yes, there are few examples that we are going to calculate in our next session. So here the theory portion of account receivable is completed. I hope you all are clear about each and every point. So that's all for today's session. Thank you, students. Thank you so much.